So the first thing comes in our mind is, what is SAP? Now, the answers which comes in your mind, most of you, if let's suppose if somebody is going to ask a common question, what do you mean by SAP? Then 95% of the people says systems, applications, product in data processing. But guys, this is not the 100% perfect answer. Why? Because this is just a full form. This is just a full form. So the question is still remain, what is SAP? Now look at here, next slide, what does it says? So the next slide says it's an ERP. It's an ERP. Now here also bit confusions will be there, because the next questions which should come in your mind or which comes in our mind is, what is ERP then? Right? So now the answers or definitions of ERP is hidden in the full form itself. And what is the full form of ERP? The full form is Enterprise Resource Planning. What are the resources in any organization? The resources in any organizations are money, man, material, and machines. That is called 4M. And planning. Planning about what? Planning about the optimum utilization. Optimum utilization, or we can say maximum utilization. So maximum utilization of what? Maximum utilization of resources. Resources of any organization. Now, if you talk about the definitions, then what will be the definitions of ERP? It's pretty simple. It's a software. ERP is nothing but a software, or we can say it's a tool. It's a software which helps an organization to do optimum or maximum utilization of its resources. What are the resources in any organizations? 4M, money, man, material, and machines. So SAP is also an ERP itself. Now, I'll just quote a pretty simple example here, guys. Just think about, we'll talk about way back, might be 30 years back, 40 years back, whenever, let's suppose, if you're going to visit any nearby banks and all, what will happen in those days, people used to carry passbooks and all, you need to stand in a long queue in order to withdraw your amounts and all, right? Let's suppose if you forgotten to carry your passbook, then what will happen? If you want to get some details and all, then again, people, whoever the bankers were there, they used to maintain all the datas, their customer datas in the registers and all. If somebody started searching your datas and all, it may take, might be 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours also. It depends upon, like, they're going to ask some questions like when your account was opened, right? Let's suppose you've forgotten your passbook or something, or let's suppose if they have to find out any details, then they're going to search lots of registers and all, when your account was opened, in which year, in which month. If you're having perfect clue, then it is going to take half an hour or 1 hour to get out all the, to get, you know, all the details. If you say it's like, okay, in this particular year, then in that also 12 months are there. So how people are going to find out again that somebody is allocated, someone, that this assignment is going to be allocated to somebody, and that guy is going to spend like, let's suppose, 2-3 hours, and after that they're going to find out some outputs, some results. Now, the same activity nowadays, let's suppose, the same thing, let's suppose if you've forgotten something, if you've forgotten some information, if you've forgotten your account number itself, let's suppose you went to BAM, wherever your nearest or whatever your branches are there. If you say your name plus any, email ID, within few seconds, they are going to tell you all the details. If you disclose your name plus mobile number, they are going to disclose all the, you know, information. Even if you say your mobile number also, they are going to find out all the details. If you say your registered email ID, they are going to find out all the details. If you say your PAN number, they are going to find all the details. Why? Because they are using certain software. The softwares are nothing but an ERP itself, right? So very less inputs we are going to give, and based on that, several outputs are going to be given by this ERP itself. Now, just think about the resources. Earlier, what is happening, guys? Number of people required to manage these all activities. Right now, only one guy is sitting on one counter and going to give you all the details. It means, like earlier, if somebody is going to spend 1 hour to give any information to one client, right now, in 1 hour, one guy is going to serve 100 clients or more than 100 clients, right? So this is the major benefit. I'll quote one more example here. It's a pretty simple example. Let's suppose this Tata Motor, this is a manufacturing organization, right? So if you talk about any organizations, there are several departments, like sales department is there, purchase department is there, finance and account department is there, human resource department is there. So these are the major departments which is there in every organization. Just take example of sales department itself. Okay, any department we can take. I've just quoted here example of sales department. Now, in sales department, Tata Motors is having total number of employees, that is 50 employees are there. Now, out of 50, 25 people are involved in day-to-day transaction posting, and remaining 25 people are involved in report preparations. Just assume that Tata Motor is not using any ERP right now. They are also maintaining everything in register itself. So now, 25 people involved in day-to-day transaction posting and remaining 25 people involved in report preparations. So if you talk about Tata Motor, it's a huge organization, and of course lots of transactions are taking place daily basis, several sales are taking place. So what will happen? Lots of invoices are going to be sent to the customers. So those invoices need to be recorded somewhere. Let's suppose they are going to maintain some sales registers. These are the transactions. Apart from this, even customers are going to return certain whatever their end product is there. Okay, so that is going to be returned by the customers. Those also need to be recorded. Customers are going to make payments also. Those also need to be recorded. So several different kind of transactions are taking place. And so 25 people, let's suppose, involved in day-to-day transactions recording. And even report is also very important. Why? Because if you talk about management, then management people are very much interested on these reports only, because based on reports, they are going to take all the future decisions and all. And apart from this, they will come to know the performance based on the reports only, right? So now, what is happening? 50 people required. If Tata Motor is planning to use any ERP, say for example SAP itself, if Tata Motor is going to use, or if Tata Motor is going to implement SAP here in their, let's suppose, in sales department itself, then what is happening? Then in that case, they need only these 25 people. They need only these 25 people. Why? Because whatever this day-to-day transactions recording activities are there that need to be performed, and this is going to be performed by this 25 people. Now, instead of maintaining the registers and all, they are going to hit the same transactions where? In SAP. So whatever the physical registers are there, that is replaced by digital registers. Now, the same transactions are going to be recorded where? It is going to be recorded in SAP. And why I said only 25 people required? Because the moment we are going to give certain inputs and all, the outputs are going to be prepared by your ERP itself automatically, in the sense the moment you are going to post the invoices or payment or whatever the other transactions are there, based on that, this SAP itself is going to prepare several kind of report automatically. Several reports are getting updated in background. So whichever this 25 people involved for this report preparations, now those people are not required. Why? Because the more accurate report is going to be prepared by SAP itself, and that too automatically. So now what is happening, guys? So here earlier the sales department, they needed total 50 people. But right now what is happening? Right now only 25 people can manage this sales department, right? So 25 people can manage easily. Whatever this remaining 25 people, software startup motor is going to use or utilize them, or their Tata Motor is going to involve them in a different activity. So look at here. Now, of course, it is going to be. So now SAP is what? SAP is an ERP itself. It's an ERP, right? And what I said during the definitions of this ERP, I says it's a software which helps an organization to do optimum utilization of its resources. Even employee is also the resources of any of a particular organization. Earlier, total 50 people were managing one department. Right now, since they have implemented a particular ERP, so what is happening? Only 25 people are able to manage this department. Whichever the surplus or remaining 25 people are there, they are going to perform a different activities. So look at here how this is ERP is going to help any organizations to do optimum utilizations of its resources. Even indirectly, money is also going to involve in that, right? Because on sales department, let's suppose they have allocated some XYZ amount for the salaries and all. Right now it become half, right? So indirectly this is also involved. Now what are the leading ERPs in the market? So the leading ERP in the markets are, of course, the first place goes to SAP itself, which is one of the leading ERP in the market. They have acquired more than 70% of the markets here. If you search on Google, they like different charts are going to be. But if you talk about the big organizations, almost 70% plus of the big organizations are using this SAP itself. Then Oracle Financial, JD Edwards, BAN, EPCore, PeopleSoft, and there are lots of other ERPs also there in the market, guys. Even Tally is also a small ERP. Like that, we are having Navision is also there, right? So several other ERPs are there, guys, in the market. Now, what are the different modules in SAP? So if you talk about SAP, it doesn't mean that we are going to learn SAP as a whole. Okay, SAP is going to be segregated in different module. Okay, what are those modules? So at broader level, first of all, it is going to be divided into two parts. The first one is called functional module and second one is called technical module. What is the exact difference between functional modules and technical modules, guys? That also will come into picture. There are several topics which will come once I start the sessions. Those topics will come into picture, and there I am going to give a more explanations and clarity on these differences and all. Okay, so At broader level, it is going to be divided into functional two part, that is functional modules and technical modules. Right now, just see here. What are the modules which comes under functional module and what are the modules which comes under technical module? So in functional modules, we are having FI, that is called finance. CO, stand for controlling. MM, material management, sales and distributions, human resource. And there are others modules also like PM, that is called plant maintenance. Then we are having PP, production planning, PS, project system, etc. In technical module, majorly ABAP and BASIS. These are the two modules which will come into picture. So we are going to focus, or we have to focus on FI and CO, finance and controlling module. Okay. Now, so this is just an introduction about SAP, guys. Now here, I'll just cover one real-time topic, so that because this introductions and all are over here, I'll cover one real-time topic so that you can come to know the way I'm explaining, how much you guys are able to understand, right? Now, so look at here, SAP projects and it types. Once you guys become SAP consultant, then what is happening? You guys are going to be assigned a project. You have to work on a particular project. So what is this project all about and how many types of projects are there? So I'll explain one by one how many types of projects are there. First of all, if you talk about a project is nothing but a task or assignment. Whichever assignment, like you guys might be, let's suppose if you have done MBA or whatever your BBA or BTech, right? So lots of, in this season itself, few of you might be from finance and account side, few of you might be from non-accounting background, right? So during your last semester, what is happening? Your college is going to give you a certain assignment that you perform this activity, you just go for market survey and all. So whichever such a assignment is there, that is going to be treated as a project, that this is a project which I have to complete. Likewise, once you become a consultant, then you are going to get an assignment that you have to work on so and so activities. So whatever this assignment is there, that is going to be treated as project. Now, if you talk about SAP project, then it is going to be divided into four part. The SAP project is going to be divided into four part. The first one is called implementation project. Then we are having rollout project, upgrade project, and support project. We'll discuss one by one. What is this implementation project? What is rollout project? What is upgrade project? And what is support project? It means what kind of activities are going to happen in these all projects. So first of all, we'll discuss about implementation project, guys. Now, implementation project means, since I have quoted an example of Tata Motor, so here also I'm just going to give you an example of Tata Motor itself. Okay.